Chaiolik is a chairde go a míle maith as on curibh an so inniu. We are in the heat of an intense election campaign. Therefore, I'm sorry I haven't had time to sit down and do a very learned dissertation on the future of the left. But I do have a few ideas following the structure of what we were asked to deal with this morning, which is the future of the left, and then policies, political strategies, and future possibilities. Obviously, in face of the current economic maelstrom, the policy that is adopted is critical. I think the programme of the United Left Alliance, which has seen the coming together of the Socialist Party, People Before Profit, the Socialists in Tipperary, and other people around the country, lays down, if you like, what should be the bedrock of that policy. And I quote, rejects so-called solution to the economic crisis based on slashing public expenditure, welfare payments, and workers' pay. There can be no just or sustainable solution to the crisis based on the capitalist market. And I think that's the first thing, that what we are seeing is a failure, an abject failure of the capitalist market in Ireland, in Europe, and indeed worldwide. And allied to that, the consequences of the insane financial markets system, whereby billions of euro are sloshing around the world and Europe. Hedge fund operators, speculators of all kinds, Goldman Sachs and the rest of them, looking for a quick return on speculative capital, irrespective of what the social consequences are. And you know, when you look at the last 2 or 3 years as the onset of the crisis in this country, you really wonder at how the entire establishment, which claims to be the last word in allegiance to democracy, have without exception bent the knee and fallen in their face in front of the capitalist markets. How many times in Morning Ireland have you heard in the last 2 years one single question put to all these economists and the others that are coming in front of it in regard to what the latest thing the government did? How will the markets react? But what will the markets think? Will this satisfy the markets? And we have indeed the entire European Union establishment, which preach around the world about the European model of democracy, and from Barroso to Van Rompuy to Trichet and the rest of them, all without fail bend the knee to the sharks and the speculators in the capitalist marketplace. Production for private profit and for private corporate profit and corporate control of investments is in an inevitable clash with the social good, as we see at the present time, their refusal to invest, and the rising unemployment in this country and many countries all over Europe. So the solution is break with the market system. And that has to be brought into this debate. Now, in the debate on the TV and the radio and so far, it's difficult to get beyond the obsession with a 19 billion deficit. You're not allowed to go wider than that by the interrogators. And that means that we have to break through this and say there is no solution to that deficit or anything else on the basis of the present system. It's a broken system and you don't look to it for solutions. So the financial institution here and Europe has to be taken into public ownership and democratic control and accountability, and then direct investment in the interests of society and developing the economy, with public investment. The natural resources like Corrib gas, for example, is an obvious one of how the resources of our society should be developed for the benefit of all. But generally, there is a huge need for major infrastructure. Look at the disaster water infrastructure, for example. On a public funding basis, it's entirely possible to address that. But major production also, in my view, a plan of production, but under democratic socialist control, not the old Stalinist model of bureaucratic control, which imploded. It was inevitable it was going to implode, and unfortunately is a barrier still in some people's mind. Democratic control of production where the resources are released and organized democratically for the benefit of society. So which policy now in the current crisis? And you have to relate it to what the solution is. The IMF-EU austerity programme is the only game in town as far as capitalism is concerned. Do we embrace that, or an alternative which means a challenge to the very basis of the capitalist market and the alternative of socialist policies? Now, the Labour Party is embracing fully the IMF-EU programme. Never mind that it spins it out over a year or two extra, talk about renegotiation and all that. It embraces the limits imposed by the key representatives of world capitalism. They rode into town here, not in the interest of the Irish people, but to save the major banks that had speculated widely on the property market. And therefore, Labour in government, which has embraced market capitalism, will continue and carry out the same programme of savage cuts, essentially, as Fianna Fáil and the Greens. Labour is a party of the establishment and will play no role whatsoever in the left in the next period of time. For the future of the Irish Labour Party, all you have to do is look to Greece, to Spain and to Portugal, where their fellow members of the social, so-called social democratic or whatever group in Europe are the ones implementing the most savage cuts in the history of those countries. The Labour and socialists, they call themselves socialist, incredibly, governments, are savaging the living standards of the working class and the public services at the diktat of the IMF and the EU. And the IMF-EU should have been seen again as a seminal moment, like 1918, like 1920s, when Labour unfortunately refused Padraig O'Donnell's request to lead the anti-land annuities campaign, which Fianna Fáil did, and won the support of the small farmers as a result. Now, Sinn Féin in the North, I will argue, find themselves in a similar contradictory situation, because their members in the North are about to implement savage cuts in education and in social spending at the behest of a Tory Liberal government in London. And you have to be consistent and honest in your policies. And I've no doubt that the activists in Sinn Féin, and I work with them, are very serious about and in their belief. But at leadership level, you cannot have a consistency of supporting cuts in one part of this island and then opposing them in the other. It's a contradiction that can't be squared. So the policy from the left has to be break with the capitalist system and put forward an alternative, which is what the United Left Alliance is attempting to do in this election. What is the strategy? An independent strategy is critical. Any support for governments of right-wing parties is of course a total betrayal of the people that we claim to represent. A left party will only be accepted in government on the basis that it is prepared to sell out on any fundamental commitment to a change in society. And that's the role that Labour has historically played. And I was in the Labour Party fighting against coalition, and people like Keane and that, frankly, you know, genuine people, leave the Labour Party and become involved in a movement that is fundamentally of the left and build a left which is independent. And that's a critical thing. Labour will go into government with Sinn Féin. Let's not have any illusions about that. But it is a question that the comrades or the colleagues in Sinn Féin have to offer as well. Because in the 2007 general election, Sinn Féin leadership was setting itself up for talks to go into government with Fianna Fáil. And even Gerry Adams, the leader of Sinn Féin, said in the last week or two, we believe in the art of compromise, we're a party of government, and didn't rule out a government with Fianna Fáil or Fine Gael. And when their activists again wanted to do that at a conference, the leadership intervened to stop it. So any participation in a government of the right is just a disaster and is not consistent with being on the left or building a left alternative. Future possibilities, Chairwoman, in conclusion. And the role of the left in the next all, which is only 3 weeks away. The United Left Alliance, which I am part, I hope will get a cohort of TDs. They will conduct themselves with principled independent policy of opposition to what will most likely be a very right-wing Fine Gael Labour Party government, oppose in the Parliament, but critically join with mobilisations of people power outside the Parliament, the reclaiming of the trade unions for its membership and as instruments of struggle against these cuts is critical. The role of the leadership of the Congress of Trade Unions against this crisis of massive proportions and the savage attacks on living standards is shameful in the extreme. Not a shot has been fired in reality by the leadership of the trade unions, who have abdicated all responsibility against the wishes and the anger of their membership, who turned out in massive numbers when they were called to, but were then demobilised immediately. In the new Dáil, left TDs will actively work with the rank and file of the trade unions to build new fighting organisations of shop stewards, activists, and empowering the members of the unions themselves to make the unions into what they were set up for. Community power is critical. We will face quite a lot of different challenges and new attacks, but two specific attacks dictated by the IMF, a water tax and a home tax. We will link up with the communities for massive campaigns of people power for a boycott of those charges, mobilising people throughout the country as we did in the 1990s and crushed the water tax at that stage, which was an important reform for PAYE workers. As Mary Hanifin, Minister, said recently, water charges on households would be €700 a year now if we hadn't defeated them in 1996. We will commit ourselves to do the same thing, and really, by linking up a cohort of principled left TDs in Dáil Éireann, we will work with Sinn Féin. We would be prepared to discuss with the Labour Party if it rejected, of course, the IMF disaster and went to the left. But that's a pipe dream. It just simply won't do that. We need to build a new mass party of the working class, which means public sector, private sector, pensioners, unemployed, the widest section of society, the 90%, if you like, that isn't in the owning banks and all the rest of it. And Europe-wide, actually, which I've travelled a lot in the last year and a half or more, you have a huge vacuum in the same way as all the parties have abandoned the left. So we have a major historical task, but I think in the course of this election and after it, that we will do our best to make a major contribution to resolve what is now an historical contradiction of such a lack of representation for ordinary working people, poor people, pensioners, and so on.
Thank you.